Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to another episode of the Old Cookbook Show. Today I'm going to do a recipe from a not very old cookbook. This was published in November 1951, but I want to do the recipe from this book because it comes from my Aunt Nell. Now, my Aunt Nell is my grandfather's sister on my father's side, so she's actually my great aunt. And I only met her maybe two or three times at big family functions because shortly after World War II, her and her husband moved to California. They moved to Carmichael, California. And the recipe today comes from the Carmichael Kitchens Cookbook, submitted by the women of Carmichael Community Church and compiled by Eve Hannah Circle, November 1951. And so Carmichael is a bedroom community of Sacramento, California. The recipe we're going to do today is called My Cake. Now, I could have contacted my cousins and asked how Aunt Nell, their grandmother, made this cake, but I didn't because I wanted to go in blind. I wanted to just sort of go through the recipe and figure it out on my own. It's a relatively simple recipe. I don't think there's too many gotchas in it, but it comes in two parts. Now, part one is what I put into this food processor, butter, flour, sugar. It's essentially a pie dough or a sugar cookie crumble crust. So we'll process this. Now, Aunt Nell's instructions were to do this by hand, but I'm going to cheat a little bit and use a food processor. I have it. Why not use it? So I'm going to put this into the bottom of a cake tin. She doesn't say what size cake tin, so I'm just using sort of my go-to standard square cake pan, and we're just going to press that into the bottom with my hand. Now we'll move on to part two, which is a filling that gets baked on top of this crust. And it is fairly simple, and it's pretty reminiscent of a couple of other recipes that we've done lately. So we're going to start out with two eggs. Next in is brown sugar, flour, and baking powder. And I'll just give that a bit of a whisk to get it going. Now, I'm also supposed to put in a pinch of salt, so let me get that. Put that in. And it calls for a cup of walnuts or half a cup of coconut. I'm not a fan of either of those, so I'm going to use pecans because I really like pecans. And I had debated using almonds or slivered almonds or chopped almonds or something like that, mostly because from my childhood, I really only met Aunt Nell once or twice. And the thing that I remember most about her was that she lived in California and would send us California almonds at Christmas time. And to a young child in the early 70s, that was a big deal to get a package from so far away with these really great tasting almonds. That was a big deal back then. Probably not so much now. Everything is available all the time from everywhere, it would seem. So I also put in a little bit of vanilla, and we're just supposed to spread it on top of part one and bake in a 350 degree oven until it's done. So in it goes, and I'll get in there with a spatula just to get the last of it.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends.
This is a fork event.
Fork event looks like cake. Or brownies.
Cake.
Cake. Chocolate?
No.
Oh.
So this is, let's see if I can get it out, the first piece out in one go.
Six. Ooh. Oh. There's cookie on the bottom.
Yes. So this is my cake from Aunt Nell. whose name properly is Helena. But I only ever heard her called Aunt Nell. H.F. Doherty.
Oh. It looks a bit like a butter tart on top.
It does. That's kind of wild, isn't it?
Except not quite as liquidy.
Yes. So a couple of eggs. That cookie on the bottom. There's pecans. You know what?
That's got a nice chewy texture to it. Cookies.
That is completely a take on a butter tart. Completely a take on a butter tart.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that amazing?
I mean, come on. Butter, sugar, corn syrup.
Yeah. But what it is missing, what the top layer is missing is butter. There's no butter. But in a butter tart, if you've watched our butter tart series, there really isn't a whole lot of butter in butter tarts. It mostly is brown sugar or brown sugar and corn syrup egg.
In the modern version.
In the modern version.
Yeah. The old version was all butter.
Yeah.
And I do believe that was our preferred butter tart recipe.
This is really good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So my cake.
Mm-hmm.
By Aunt Nell.
Mm-hmm. That's a winner. That is definitely a winner. I would put that on your dinner table or your dessert table or your dessert sideboard. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.